I'm Mashi Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Haumph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
Hello, hello. So, yeah, I mean, this is an interesting pack. Obviously, I'm doing some cube here for all you Channel Fireball viewers today. I mean, I don't want to take Baneslayer Angel. I could maybe take Natural Order instead. That's pretty powerful and can do some crazy things, but I mean, it's Baneslayer Angel. Even in cube, Baneslayer Angel is still really good. Daxos seems like fun too, but yeah, I've got to just take the card that's awesome. So here we have a fair number of awesome cards. Obviously Hand of Honor is what goes well with my first pick, but I mean, do I really want to take Hand of Honor second? Probably not. I think Scavenging Ooze is probably the most powerful card in the pack, followed by maybe, gosh, I don't even know what follows that. Everflowing Chalice is pretty good in cube. Stomping Ground might be the pick. Chromox is certainly awesome in some decks, but not every deck. It's actually kind of a tough pick. I think I'm going to pick Scavenging Ooze and see where I go. Because this card, it can be really good. Ooh, Worn Power Stone is nice, and Terminus is kind of fun. Avenger of Zendikar is certainly extremely good. But then there's Gia's Cradle, and Gia's Cradle, you can make some insane decks with Gia's Cradle. And I'm not sure there's anything I like in this pack more than Gia's Cradle. I wish I could snag the Gia's Cradle and the Avenger. But that is just not possible. Alright, well, I have an early green creature already. I think I'm going to take Gia's Cradle and just start building around that. Because really, that card is pretty insane in the right deck. And now we have fair number of okay cards. Flicker Wisp is actually fairly good, but it's a lot better in Aether Vial decks. I don't think I want to take something like Flint Hoof Boar this early. Tradewind Rider is pretty disgusting. Wildfire is not the deck I'm building so far. Overgrown Tomb is a possibility, just to kind of keep my options open. Weathered Wayfarer is fine, and it's another card that works kind of nicely with Cradle. But I don't know if I want to be a white-green Cradle deck. That's maybe a little awkward. I don't know. I'm going to run it, though. Yeah. We'll see. Ooh, Parallax Wave. There's a fun card. I'm trying to figure out if I want to take Parallax Wave here, or if I just want to take something more consistent. Like, I could take Curdape and plan to be that deck. That deck certainly can utilize a Cradle to cast its high-cost spells. But I have the Baneslayer and the Weathered Wayfarer already. And this card is just so very versatile. we're just going to take the wave. And here, I'm just going to take Vengevine. That seems really easy. Yeah, Vengevine definitely fits my fits what I have so far. Floodplain's a little bit slow. Raging Ravine would be nice, but I mean, Gifts being here this late is kind of nuts too. Gifts is really good in this format, and so is Diabolic Servitude for that matter. Best reanimation card. But I'm just going to take Vengevine. And maybe I'll find ways to use it. So Wicker Bow Elder is a card. Hallowed Burial, another Wrath effect. And even though Elder is a card, I think I'm just going to take Wooded Bastion here and try and shore up my mana. Wicker Bow Elder isn't quite as good in this cube as it is in some. So, we'll go with this. So here, I'm going to consider maybe adding some red and playing Woolly Thoctar. Although it's looking more and more awkward for me, because there's a 3 Wrath deck somewhere out there. I could just take Volcanic Island as well. But Volcanic Island just doesn't do anything with what I've got so far, whereas Woolly Thoctar might actually be a pretty good fit. But I do kind of need to get some things to work with the Cradle. It'd be nice if, yep, this Tooth and Nail came back. That's kind of what I was hoping for. Surprised to see both of these cards here. Both of those are good value creatures, although Liliana's Reaver is pretty kind of iffy. But I think, maybe I have to take Tooth and Nail here. Or Memory Jar. Memory Jar is even better with Cradle than Tooth and Nail. Yeah, never mind. I'm taking Memory Jar here. Yeah, Memory Jar is the pick. And now I'm definitely taking Stomping Ground. Even though, I don't know, Experiment 1 would be... is quite the card in this deck. Gosh, so many good cards available. Alright, I have to believe that I'm going to be getting more early drops somewhere. So I'm just going to take the Stomping Ground. So now I've got Wheel of Fortune, another pretty good card with Cradle. But not that great. It's not quite as good as Memory Jar, where you can just jar and play like everything, and then your opponent discards their stuff. I think Wheel of Fortune is good enough, though, that I'm going to take it over Treetop Village. And now I can definitely take this Flinthoof Boar, which I'm glad came back. And oh wow, this Curdabe came back too. This deck is real. Aurelia's Fury would be nice in a Cradle deck as well, obviously if you get red, white, and... gosh, that's tough, but I'm going to take the Curdabe because I need early creatures. And I'm going to take Raging Ravine here, probably will end up playing that card. Very surprised Prophetic Bolt came around last. Even in cube, it's nice to have legitimate 2-for-1s. So this deck is kind of developing. I have a couple of things that I can use with early mana producers. I've got Wheel, I've got Jar. Ooh, now I've got possibility of Court of Calling. That might be really good. I also could just keep it simple and take Tarmogoyf. Siege Gang Commander, obviously really good synergy with Cradle, but a little bit awkward with what I have so far. Another Wrath effect that's lovely for my aggro deck to see. I don't know. I don't really want to pass Tarmogoyf, to be honest. There are so many cards that are just so good once you have the Cradle going, but I've kind of got, I mean, I've got two of those already. Yeah, I think I'm going to take Tarmogoyf here. Just to have another really good early creature. And I have some things that work well with it, like Wheel of Fortune, for instance. I'm probably wrong. Probably just a little bit obsessed with Tarmogoyf, to be honest. Okay, so Fleece Mane Lion is a card that's very good with Cradle, because you not only can start getting your Cradle going with it, but it's something where it uses the mana from Cradle very well. So that's a real option. Hero of Bladehold is another card that is good in this deck, but it's a little bit white heavy. I don't know. Gruul Turf is not good enough to take this early. And I don't think I want to go into blue to get Geist of St. Traft. So it's basically between the Lion and the Hero. And I think I'm actually going to take the Hero. Even though that's harder to cast. Ooh, so Domrirod is there. Then we've got Savannah. And that's actually kind of a tough pick, but I mean, Domri is looking like it's going to be very good in my deck. Yeah, just that plus one is going to draw cards a lot. I'm going to have early creatures that help to defend the Domri. Yeah, that just seems more important than a Savannah right now. As much as I hate passing Savannah, and of course Plow Under, which is really sick in this deck. But Domri it is. And so now we have a Courser of Grufix. We have a Linvala as well, which is a nice card. If I was going to be splashing blue, Hinterland Harbor would be helpful. But I think I just want to play Courser here. Courser Domri is kind of a nice combo, actually. Especially if you get some shuffle effects to go with it, like the Wayfarer, for instance. And I just love this card. So I think what I need at this point is some sort of reasonable way to stay in longer games. Ooh, Genesis Wave. See, now we're kind of talking. Genesis Wave seems like a fun fit. I don't know. That's tough, though. Genesis Wave. I'm kind of going all over the place with this deck. If I don't take Wave, I can take, like, Mirror Battlesphere or Wall of Reverence. Obviously, Wall of Reverence isn't so bad. It gives me a chance to stay alive for longer games, avoid getting like counter aggroed. But I mean, Genesis Wave seems so awesome. I want more mana producers. Like I probably should have taken Explore earlier. So this is a fairly uninspiring pack. I could take Oust so that I at least have a little bit of removal going. I could just take Borderland Ranger. I think it's kind of that or Karbluzin Forest. And I'm actually going to take Ranger here. Gosh, wish I could take Phantasmal Image, but I just don't think that I have the tools to go blue. Oust is... yeah, it's tough. I don't want to be giving them life when I'm trying to be aggressive. Okay, so now we have the option of this Chandra. Not exactly the best Chandra. Or close to the best Chandra. I could get Lantax, but I don't really have anything that works with Lantax right now. And there's a Plateau in the pack. Plus Regrowth, but more importantly, the Plateau. So I think I'm going to take Plateau here. Meh. I don't have any of the artifacts that I would need to work with Lantax. Like, if I had Chrome Mox, I'd probably go with Lantax there. Ooh, Mirari's Wake. Blastoderm. Brushland is not in the picture. It's between Wake and Blastoderm. Alright, I'm going to take Mirari's Wake and hope that I can get more things to use all of this big mana that I'm getting. Yeah. Alright, so the Siege Gang came back, so did Court of Calling. That's actually really tough. But I'm going to grab Siege Gang here. Cord would be nice, but I don't have anything to cord into yet, other than Baneslayer Angel. Baneslayer Angel's a pretty nice one. But I think I need the Siege Gang more. Could just be dead wrong on that, to be honest. So I'm not a fan of Beast Within as a rule. It's not really the kind of card I enjoy playing. But, I mean, this pack doesn't really have anything else for me. I'm certainly not a descendant of Kiyomaro deck. And I don't think Gruul Turf is fast enough to be played, so we're going to do this. Ooh, Savannah came back? What? Mog War Marshal is a nice fit in the deck, but this is a Savannah. I'm just going to take Savannah. And now I'm going to take away Ratchet Bomb. That card's really not something I want to play against, I don't believe. I don't really want to play against this guy either, to be honest, but yeah, we'll take the bomb. So, I could see Lumberjack fitting in my deck. It is an early creature. And it's not like I'm worried about these cards particularly getting around. I'll probably play this Carpluzan Forest, so I might as well take it. And Attrition. That's something my deck is not good at.